Let's have a nice round of applause for Martene Craig and the ARISE Bell Ringers and String Players from Colony High School. Colony's director is Michael Bachman in their performance of Ovation of Praise. And now, Let It Ring, featuring soloist Lori Banta. In biblical times, the vision of new life arising from dry bones provided the homesick Israelites with hope that the dry bones of defeated Israel would come back to life, and they could one day be free of their oppressors, the Babylonians. Before the American Civil War, many black men and women in the United States found themselves in a situation like that of the Israelites, having been forcibly relocated from their homelands and brought to the United States to serve as slaves. They were able to keep their hopes alive in part through singing songs that spoke of freedom. One way this was done was by singing spirituals, songs whose lyrics referred to stories from the Bible that carried themes of hope and freedom. Songs like Go Down Moses, Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, and Wade in the Water. They make no direct references to freedom, but use the imagery of scattered bones being reconnected to encode the same message of hope. Dem bones, or dry bones, or dem dry bones, is a well-known traditional spiritual. Tonight, we present the ARISE Ringers and Jeff Millard and Quillan Garrido in a Spike Jones version of Dry Bones.
Dem bones, dem dry bones.
Dem bones, dem bones, dem dry bones.
Dem bones, dem bones, dem dry bones. Now hear the word of the Lord.
Foot bone.
Ankle bone.
Ankle bone.
Leg bone.
Leg bone.
Thigh bone.
Thigh bone.
now hear the word of the Lord. Hip bone.
Head bone,
now hear the word of the Lord. Them bones gonna walk around.
Them bones gonna walk around. Now hear the word of the Lord.
Staines is an American folk musician and singer-songwriter from New Hampshire who writes and performs songs about a wide array of topics. He's also written and recorded many children's songs. His songs include Bridges, Crossing the Water, Sweet Wyoming Home, and A Place in the Choir. Staines' songs have been published in 4 songbooks, including one entitled All God's Critters Got a Place in the Choir. Tonight, we will hear an arrangement by Celtic Thunder of A Place in the Choir. The song features Danny Fernandez, Bill Brogy, Mike Geyer, and Jeff Millard. So let us all get prepared to join in and clap our hands or paws or anything we got now.
All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing high, and some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing high, and some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands. Listen to the top where the little bird sings with the melodies and the high notes ringing and the hoot owl cries over everything and the blackbird disagrees.
Singing in the nighttime, singing in the day when the little duck quacks and he's on his way. The otter hasn't got much to say and the porcupine talks to himself.
All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing high, and some sing out loud on a telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws for anything they got now.
Dogs and cats, they take up the middle where the honeybee hums and the cricket fiddles. The donkey brays and the pony neighs and the old gray badger sighs.
Listen to the bass, it's the one on the bottom where the bullfrog croaks and the hippopotamus moans and groans with a big to-do. And the old cow just goes, ooh. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or paws or anything they got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir.
ox and the fox and the grizzly bear, the dopey alligator and the hog above, the sly old eagle and the turtle dove. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or pause for anything they got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or pause for anything they got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir. Some sing low and some sing higher. Some sing out loud on the telephone wire. Some just clap their hands or pause for anything they got now. All God's creatures got a place in the choir.
Join me in giving a round of applause to director Martene Craig and the ARISE Joy Ringers, Singers, and Stringers, and the string players from Colony High School.
Well, good evening. My name is Dr. George Matamala, and I am the proud principal of the Chafee Adult School. Welcome to beautiful and historic Gardner W. Spring Auditorium and the Ontario Chafee Community Show Band's performance of Music of the 80s. It's now a pleasure. Yeah, 80s, of course. It's my decade. It's now my great pleasure to introduce my co-host for this evening, retired long-term member of the Chafee Joint Union High School District Board of Trustees, Mr. Charles Uhaley.
Good evening. I am delighted to co-host this exciting performance with George. Anyone who made it through the 60s and 70s has got to remember the 80s. The show band and ARISE Ensemble has put together a great repertoire of selections from the 80s and several inspirational songs that we all know very well. In addition to ARISE Ensemble, the concert will highlight with solos by show band flutist Diane Rawlings and trombonist Stephen Cavaretta, and the outstanding musicians of the Ontario Chafee Community Show Band. Okay, George, take it away.
The show band's first selection is a tune written by rock musician and singer-songwriter Kenny Loggins. It was used as the theme music for the 1980 comedy film Caddyshack. The track was released as a single in 1980 and then reached the top 10 of the U.S. singles chart. The song is also one of the most frequent choices in Loggins' concerts and is included in all of his official concert material releases. It is now my pleasure to introduce director Dr. Gabe Petruccelli as he leads the show band in I'm All Right.
Before we start, we've been publicizing for the last couple of weeks. Our guest artist would be Gigi Garner. And unfortunately, she was not able to be here. She's ill. We're a microcosm of the larger community, and we have sickness too. The issue was that she was going to do about a third of the concert. And so why I'm sharing this with you is because I'm forever grateful to my dear friend Martene for filling in and starting with her, let me see if I get this right, ringers, singers, and stringers. Did I get that right, Martene? So the four songs that Jana was going to sing, we are going to do at another concert. So we'll keep you informed, but I want to thank you and these wonderful people for filling in tonight. Thank you.
In 1984, the American rock band The Cars recorded a song that was included in their album, Heartbreak City. Upon its release, it became The Cars' highest charted single and peaked at number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100. The song is most associated with the July 1985 Live Aid event in Philadelphia. The song was also used in London as background music to a montage of clips depicting the Ethiopian famine. Tonight, Stephen Cavaretta is featured on trombone in an instrumental version of the song. Let us give him a round of applause as he performs Drive. The show band will be conducted by David Grasmick.
Thank you. The ARISE Ensemble has members who come from several churches in the Inland Empire and perform a repertoire of music that includes spirituals, well-known hymns and gospel songs, folk and show tunes, country, patriotic, and seasonal selections. The ensemble serves in a variety of venues that includes churches, retirement homes, concert halls, and prisons. Their next selection is from The Phantom of the Opera, written by Andrew Lloyd Webber. What makes the Phantom of the Opera song unique is its unusual hard rock style, while most of the songs in the musical have a more operatic style. This song is sung by the character Christine for her audition and then at a performance in an opera. The lyric of the song itself is asking someone to think of the singer even though they are far away. Lori Banta now sings Think of Me.
I want to think of you.
The next song describes the pure passionate love and pain caused by another person. Recording star Adele Laurie Blue Atkin, who is known as Adele, was in a relationship that was not good for her. She would not listen to those around her, and she was determined to make it work. But then she came to realize that she needed to break it off, and so, angrily, she did. The next day, Adele was scheduled at the recording studio. There, she wrote the song, and the recording became the final track for her first number one hit, not only in the United States, but all over the world. The lyric, "You'll pay me back in kind and reap just what you sow," was taken from the Bible. Basically, your actions will come back to bite you or bless you, depending on whether you sow hatred or love. Sit back and enjoy Rolling in the Deep under the direction of Martene Craig. Thank you. It is now my pleasure to introduce the president of the Friends of the Show Band, Mr. Everything, Gary Ovid.
Well, are we being treated tonight or not? Ringers, singers, stringers, percussionists, horns, what have I missed? Don't tell me, but anyway. We are, what an outstanding concert it's beginning to be, and we are so delighted that you are here with us. You know, we are very fortunate. We have a lot of people who have come. How many of you
have not been to the auditorium before, and this is your first time? Raise your hand. I know the class of 72 is out there somewhere. Let us know where you are.
Out here.
Out here. They, yeah, talked with them earlier. So it's great to have you here. It's great to have all of you here. This is such a
wonderful facility that we have. At this time, I'd like to thank the Showband production team and our hardworking support staff that include librarians Miriam Keith, Gary Keith, Bill Bescoby, Susan Petricelli, and Crystal Leonard. Also, our Gardner W. Spring technician, Chris King, stage manager, Homero Chavez, band manager, Bob Mattis, and the assistant band manager, Steve Collins. Steve, stand up. Steve ran the L.A. Marathon. He is a legacy marathoner. He's run every single L.A. Marathon, over 1,000 miles. Well done, Steve. We also want to thank the entire equipment crew, without whose assistance this performance would not have been possible. We want to thank Karen Greenwood and the Magnolia Video Productions. They are the ones filming for us. The City of Ontario, who is obviously our big sponsor. The Inland Valley Daily Bulletin and the Chaffee Adult School. Thank you, Mr. Principal. He's not the only principal person here, but the show band photographer, Steve Davis, we want to thank him for all of the outstanding camera work he has done. Lithographer Scott Noble for producing our concert program. Our wonderful hospitality team that have been out there in the foyer, Ruby Levitt, Robin DeNegri, and John Hart, and they're there serving cookies and coffee, trying to keep you awake. So we appreciate all that they do. And you too can join if you have an interest. Just let us know or let one of them know, and we would love to pull you onto the team. The Chaffee High School Junior ROTC Corps of Naval Cadets, they're so helpful out there, helping people in, and we sure appreciate them. And the main reason I'm here is to thank the generous show sponsors and donors who are listed on the back of our program. You too can support this show band by taking an information card or an envelope at the information table, or by simply visiting the Hungry Tuba.
It's a vegetarian tuba, it likes green. So feed it a salad if you would. We would appreciate it very much. We also have a lot of dignitaries
who are here, and if I may, I'd like to introduce them. We have our Ontario City Treasurer, Jim Milheiser. Our Chaffee Joint Union High School District Board President, Sue Ovid. I'm confessing to her, Billie Jean is not my lover either. Is that right? They're going to play that soon. Chris Cruz, Upland School District Board Member. Eric Monte, Cucamonga School District Board Member. The Superintendent for the Chaffee Joint Union High School District, Dr. Matthew Holton. The Assistant Superintendent, Dr. Kern Oduro. One of the friends, the Vice President for the Friends, Al Bowling, for retired Ontario City Manager. The Secretary for the Friends of the Show Band, Gary Keith. And a great friend of ours who has taken on the role of sponsoring the Christmas show, that's Richard Ortiz. Thank you, Richard, for all you do. We are just delighted that you are here. This is what makes Monday night special. Please come back and join us every time if you have a chance, because you will not be disappointed, and we'd love to have you. We also are very thankful to have Charles Uhaley here. It's good to bring him out of retirement.
He served on our board for over 40 years. Outstanding. He has a
Altaloma High School football field is named for him. Very deserving. Thank you again.
Thank you, Gary. Okay, we're moving up to 1987. In 1987, American singer Whitney Houston recorded a song written by George Merrill and Shannon Rubicam for her second studio album entitled Whitney. It was released as the album's lead single on May 2nd, 1987, and went on to win the Grammy Award for Best Female Pop Vocal Performance, marking Houston's second win in the category. The song also won the award for Favorite Pop Rock Single at the 15th American Music Awards on January 25th, 1988. Tonight, the show band features flutist, oboist, Dana Rawlings in her interpretation of I Wanna Dance With Somebody. Let's give Dana an exciting round of applause.
Testing.
Thank you.
absolutely beautiful. The number one hit of the 80s decade was a song written by Michael Jackson. It was released on January 2nd, 1983, as a second single from his sixth studio album, Thriller, recorded in 1982. The tune blends post-disco, rhythm and blues, funk, and dance pop. The lyrics describe a woman, Billie Jean, who claimed that the narrator is the father of her newborn son, which he denies. The song reached number one on the Billboard Hot 100 and became Jackson's fastest rising number one single since ABC, The Love You Save, and I'll Be There. It was one of the best-selling singles of 1983, helping Thriller become the best-selling album of all time, and one of the best-selling digital singles of all time. Join me in a round of applause as the show band performs Billie Jean. The ad-lib saxophone solo will be played by Pat Arnold. We'll be right back.
It is now time in our concert for all the ensembles to join and perform several inspirational songs. The first is an audience-friendly song written by John Moore and John Mays on a bus as they toured with a singing group. It reached national acclaim after Sandy Patty's rendition of the Star-Spangled Banner was included during the ABC Statue of Liberty rededication broadcast on July 6, 1986. Sandy was in love with this song as soon as she heard it. She said, "This one seemed very universal to me. It was also nearing the time that the Gulf War was about to begin, and it felt powerful to sing a song that said love does not have any boundaries. Love is just love." The soloists this evening are Cat White and Danny Fernandez. Please give them and all the groups a heartfelt round of applause as they perform Love in Any Language.
Pulls us all together. Razor's going to talk.
Okay. I think it's my turn.
You're the boss.
I'm glad I made a right turn here a couple of times today. Heartfelt thanks to the greatest show band in all the land and musicians behind me. Thank you. They did a great job not knowing what was going on until they got here today. So I appreciate everything. And sincere thanks to the Woodwind Celebration. Stand up, folk, the four musicians. They are talented, and they provide your pre-concert recitals every month, and I'm very pleased to have them aboard. Many thanks to Gary Ovid. Where are you, Gary? Thank you, Gary, and all of the esteemed members of the Friends Board. They do a fantastic job for this show band. Sue, thank you for your assistance also. And also the generosity of the Millheiser family for sponsoring this performance this evening. Okay, our distinguished narrator, Susan Petricelli in the back, Dr. George Malamala. Stand up, George, he's my boss. And longtime member of the Chafee Board of Trustees, Mr. Charles Uhaley. Thank you, Charles. I want to thank also David Schaffsman for working with me today, because I didn't find out that we had to rewrite the show until about 9 o'clock. And so we had to redo the script, we had to redo the slideshow. So David, thank you very much. Stand up. And our talented conductor, David Grasmick. Where are you, David? And our two soloists, Dana Rawlings. Dana, stand up. Stephen Cavaretta, stand up. Members of the Colony High School String Orchestra under the direction of Michael Bachman. And our outstanding special guest, the ARISE Ringers. The ARISE Singers. And the ARISE Stringers. And also my dear, dear friend, Martene Craig. And then finally, I want to thank you all for coming this evening. Thank you, and hope to see you again next month.
On behalf of Dr. Petricelli and the entire show band family, the Chafee Adult School, Chafee High School, and my co-host, Charles Uhaley, I want to sincerely thank you for spending your evening with us. We hope that you've enjoyed tonight's performance. I look forward to seeing all of you once again in Merton Hill Auditorium on April 15th for the show band's An Evening at the Pops.
This evening's concert concludes with a medley of two inspirational songs by Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein. One is a show tune from their 1945 musical, Carousel. The song was sung to comfort and encourage the character Julie Jordan after her husband committed suicide. It is also reprised in the final scene of the musical. The second song is from the 1959 Rodger and Hammerstein's musical, The Sound of Music. It is sung at the close of Act One by Mother Abyss, and is themed as an inspirational piece to encourage people to take every step toward their dreams. The Sound of Music is such a wonderful example of knowing the will of God for one's life. Please give the outstanding musicians of the Chopin, ARISE Ensemble, and the Colony High School string players a rousing round of applause as they perform You'll Never Walk Alone and Climb Every Mountain. The soloists are Mike Geyer and Lauren Carpenter. Thank you.
Don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of the storm is a golden sky where the sweet silver song. Walk on
Thank you for being here tonight. Good evening. Stay healthy and drive home safely. See you at the next show.
Is a pool.